I was born in the beautiful Central American country that is Honduras. The sounds, birds chirping, my neighbor's car engine, kids laughing. The memories I have are good ones. We were a small village in a fascinating land where neighbors knew their neighbors. The whole town had a family vibe that was based on love and community, not on blood. During these first 7 years of my life, Honduras was all that I knew.
I was like 11, 10 years old, coming out of fifth grade. I always felt like the parents of the other kids didn't really want me to be in there. Like, they knew I wasn't, I guess they knew I was like not a legal citizen. And I was like, I'm an immigrant and all of that, like all of that cliche stuff. And then they would see like the type of stuff that I would do, not bad stuff. I was just like really excel in my classes. I would always try to be like the best in everything. I've always been that type of kid. I've always been really determined, I guess. I feel like the teachers just didn't like it, I guess. And then they would try to limit me. I always liked it over there. It wasn't like we were poor or anything. We were a pretty nice family, decent family in Honduras. I don't remember anything bad about it. All I could remember are like good things. Never saw like bad things in Honduras. Like usually people, when they hear about Honduras, they just think about violence and gangs and crime and all of that. And yeah, I'm pretty sure there's a bunch of that over there, but I never saw it.
I remember it being a morning like this, just a little bit less hotter.
I remember when I woke up, my mom was like, oh, we're leaving. I was like, where? She was like, oh, we're going to the United States. And then it took me by surprise. I mean,
I never pictured us leaving. I never had a reason. I never had like seen a reason to leave Honduras.
And then she told me, she's like, we're leaving. It's like, all right, mom. Like, she already packed the bags and all that. And I was like, I guess we're leaving.
Creo que casi no fue muy específico, solo eso, porque fue rápido.
And then we left. I remember we took a bus. The first bus we took, I think it took us to the border of Honduras and Guatemala. And then I remember when we got off the bus, we came to like a little river, and there was like homemade rafts, I guess. They were like made out of wood. And then the guys, like the man that were charging us to practically cross us over.
And then Mexico, I feel like it was the hardest place. And I remember I was walking, and while I was walking, I kept on kicking the rocks. And then my mom, she already had told me to like stop doing that, because the guy on the spotlight was gonna hear us, and then they were gonna catch us. And then she told me that twice, and then I didn't listen. I kept on doing it. The soldier on the spotlight, he like turned really quick. It was just like super quick. And then the spotlight like pretty much hit me. And I kind of froze. Something hit me in the back of the head, and it was actually my mother. She got really pissed at me because we would have gotten caught because of me. Yeah, just thinking about it, I remember how hard she hit me. She just like hit me with the back of her hand. In the back of the head, I mean. And I fell, and I still got some scars in my knee. I got that one. And then I also got this one. After that, I listened to my mom a lot. I was just like, I need to like listen to what she says, to what she tells me, and actually do what she tells me to do. We saw the river, and then it was called El Rio Grande, and it was like the main river immigrants used to cross from Mexico to the United States. And like, you could clearly see Texas on the other side of the river. And she was like, my mom was like, oh, that's where we're going, that's where your aunt lives, and all of that.
Ya cuando llegamos a Houston, me acuerdo que para cruzar, teníamos que esperar que la cosa estuviera calmada.
Y ya después tuvimos que agarrar un bus en la mañana para coger pan de tu prima, que ya llegamos bien tarde. Y ya pues ya solo llegamos que a bañarte, a sentirnos bien un poco en el calor de hogar, cuando ya el esposo de mi prima te enseñó tu primera palabra en inglés.
Anytime there was like lunchtime or like, yeah, just lunchtime, he would just look at me and then he would be like, Kentucky, Kentucky. And I was like, the first time he did it, I just looked at him like, what the hell is wrong with this guy? And then after a while, like, I remember watching TV one day, and then there was like the advertisement or the commercial for Kentucky Fried Chicken came on.
You got a right to chicken done right.
I make it tender, juicy, every bite.
And then I looked at him while the commercial was going on, and then I looked at him and then I was like, oh, Kentucky. But the first thing I saw was like the buildings, like everybody else. And I was like, wow. I was like, mom, look at the lights. I was accepted into the Expeditionary Learning School for Community Leaders. It's an amazing school. Like I told them before, leaders, that's what we call it, leaders. Practically brought my passion for learning again. Like, the same way I felt in Honduras, this determined, this driven kid, that same feeling came back to me when I got into leaders. I'm not a citizen or a resident. It just makes things harder, but at the end of the day, I've gone through worst, and this is another stumble. And I'm pretty sure I'll go through it fine, and I'll get a college education, and that's my goal right now.
Muchas etapas que poco a poco las hemos ido, creo que venciendo los dos juntos, porque siempre hemos estado como que muy apegados y siempre hemos tenido química para hacer las cosas. Creo que por eso también nos ha ido bien.
¿Valió la pena?
Claro que valió la pena.
It's my story, I guess, so far. Pretty decent story, I guess. Nice story. There's a lot left, though. A lot left. And I can't wait.